ಗಣನಾಯಕಾಯ ಗಣದೈವತಾಯ ಗಣಾಧ್ಯಕ್ಷಾಯ ಧೀಮಹಿ ಗುಣಶರೀರಾಯ ಗುಣಮಂಡಿತಾಯ ಗುಣೇಶಾನಾಯ ಧೀಮಹಿ ಗುಣಾತೀತಾಯ ಗುಣಾಧೀಶಾಯ ಗುಣಪ್ರವಿಷ್ಟಾಯ ಧೀಮಹಿ ಏಕದಂತಾಯ ವಕ್ರತುಂಡಾಯ ಗೌರೀತನಯಾಯ ಧೀಮಹಿ ಗಜೇಶಾನಾಯ ಬಾಲಚಂದ್ರಾಯ ಶ್ರೀ ಗಣೇಶಾಯ ಧೀಮಹಿ ಚತುರಾಯ ಗಾನ ಪ್ರಾಣಾಯ ಗಾನಾಂತರಾತ್ಮನೇ ಗಾನೋತ್ಸುಕಾಯ ಗಾನಮತ್ತಾಯ ಗಾನೋತ್ಸುಕ ಮನಸೇ ಗುರು ಪೂಜಿತಾಯ ಗುರುದೈವತಾಯ ಗುರುಕುಲಸ್ಥಾಯಿನೇ ಗುರು ವಿಕ್ರಮಾಯ ಗುಹ್ಯ ಪ್ರವರಾಯ ಗುರವೇ ಗುಣಗುರವೇ ಗುರುದೈತ್ಯ ಗಲಕ್ಷೇತ್ರೇ ಗುರುಧರ್ಮ ಸದಾರಾಧ್ಯಾಯ ಗುರುಪುತ್ರ ಪರಿತ್ರಾತ್ರೇ ಗುರು ಪಾಖಂಡ ಖಂಡಕಾಯ ಗೀತ ಸಾರಾಯ ಗೀತ ತತ್ವಾಯ ಗೀತ ಗೋತ್ರಾಯ ಧೀಮಹಿ ಗೂಢ ಗುಲ್ಫಾಯ ಗಂಧಮತ್ತಾಯ ಗೋಜಯ ಪ್ರದಾಯ ಧೀಮಹಿ ವಕ್ರತುಂಡಾಯ ಗೌರೀತನಯಾಯ ಧೀಮಹಿ ಗಜೇಶಾನಾಯ ಬಾಲಚಂದ್ರಾಯ ಶ್ರೀ ಗಣೇಶಾಯ ಧೀಮಹಿ
friends and well-wishers. On behalf of management, staff and students of NSM, I, as the head leader, extend you all the warm welcome for the investiture ceremony 2018-19. In India, there are only three premier schools of planning and architecture institutions, Delhi, Bhopal, and of course, one in Vijayawada. Professor Meenakshi Jain is the director of prestigious School of Planning and Architecture from 2016 at Vijayawada. She has 26 years of teaching experience before taking charge as the director of this institute. Professor Meenakshi Jain is able and effective administrator, young and dynamic leader, creative and innovative in our doing and being, and all the more inspiring leader for 600 students who are going to study in the institute. We, as NSMIs, are extremely glad to have you as the chief guest of the function. A hearty welcome to you, madam. Our guest of honor, J. Sunil Kumar, presently working as senior section officer, CBSE board, COE, Kakinada. Mr. Sunil Kumar, a student of Bandra Rayala College, had always thirst for knowledge right from the beginning. Mr. Sunil Kumar equipped himself educationally and professionally, finished the MSc in Maths and Physics, MA in Human Rights, and LLB. Professionally, he equipped himself Diploma in Telecommunication, Computer Programming, Software Technology, Cyber Crime, and Cyber Law. He was the principal of secondary school run by MHRD of India. He is nominated for International Peace Ambassadors Award 2018 by International Ambassadors for Peace Corporation USA, recognized by UNO. His thirst for knowledge, vast experience in the field of education, exposure and experience in attending seminars and conferences nationally and internationally, has groomed him to be effective administrator as section officer, CBSE, COE, Kakinada. Thanks for accepting our invitation and gracing the occasion all the way from Kakinada. A hearty welcome to you, sir. My warm welcome to all the parents who are present in sizable numbers, have come to witness and enjoy the program as your children are taking up the various responsibilities as leaders in various disciplines of the school. Thank you, parents, for your support, encouragement, and cooperation. Dear students, today we are celebrating the Leadership Day in NSM. Leaders are not just born to be leaders. Leaders become leaders through experiences. The responsibilities you are entrusted are stepping stones to success. You are groomed by the faculty members of our school as young and youthful leaders to be great leaders of tomorrow. A true leader is one who has leadership qualities, able to handle responsibilities, takes initiatives, leads others as an inspiring model to be imitated and creates more leaders through your responsibilities, all the more through decentralization of your responsibilities. As each one of you is entrusted with responsibilities, I pray and urge to give your best and do your best. Be dynamic and energetic leaders. May God bless you all. And we also thank God for the wonderful weather that He has given to us to organize this investiture ceremony 2018-19. Though 2 days back we had heavy showers. May God bless you all and wish you all the best as leaders who are taking up the responsibilities in various activities of the school.
Thank you, guys.
Secretary. marching behind the boss of skirts and the gentle winner of our skirts who are being led in by the vice captain. Kumari PNXS, we are holding the placard and Kumari Santos.
Members of this house are set to give a tough competition in all the events. This house is a... Close on the heels of the Patel House Girls is the Tiger House Girls continent being led in card.
And House Captain Kumari K. Durga Soumya holding the flag. Rabindranath Tagore's
the Assistant Social Service Club Secretary.
NSM School, he came to School of Planning and Architecture, Vijayawada, for the investiture ceremony. I was very glad to accept this invitation because this was the first time for me also to have a look at the investiture ceremony. which has been conducted wonderfully. I'm very pleased, sir, to be the part of this. I'm really honored and have the privilege to see this for the first time. And I can say the school is already in the safe hands, sir. And now they will become the great leaders themselves. The kind of show they put up in front of me, the kind of commitment, dedication they have shown today, that is marvelous, remarkable. They have bring the name of the school, which is very well known in Vijayawada. As I shared with you, I came to this school last year also with my daughter with me to admit her here. But everybody told me that school has a very good name, and I see a sea change here. Since the last year, sir, I mean, it is because of your hardships, you and your faculty members and the staff and the students have done a wonderful job. Within a year, the school has a complete changeover. I'm very glad to be the part of this. So for being the leader for all, I also congratulate all the cabinet, the house vice presidents, presidents, and other members, and all the students, that now their role is even greater. Swearing the investiture ceremony, you have the great responsibility in front of you. I'm sure you know all the basic traits that a leader should have, that you are already showcased, but still I would like to share some of the views that I have. Winston Churchill, he had said once that the leaders, they inspire for the mountain's top, but they are groomed in the valleys. So that is very true. This is how the school grooms its very leaders. And India, as I said, is in the very safe hands. And I believe some of the traits for such as truthfulness, dedication, commitment, preservation, resilience, already you have displayed. But still I would like to share some of the important traits such as character. I would also name in the course a few leaders such as Swami Vivekananda, our honorable late president APG Abdul Kalam ji, Indira Nui, who is the chairperson, PepsiCo, and Sundar Pichai, who must be the inspiration for many of you, and then Mark Zuckerberg. I am sure everybody of you into Facebook and WhatsApp, who is the founder of it. You must have heard various lessons, you know, out of these leaders, and I would like to quote a few of them. Swami Vivekananda, once when he was traveling in a train along with this US lady, one lady pointed it out to him after looking. He was a spiritual monk, in Hindi monk, and he was wearing very dhoti and kurta. And the lady saw at him and looked at him and saw and told him that, why don't you wear a good dress such as suit, tie, etc. and become a gentleman? What he replied, Swami Vivekananda replied, that in my country, madam, it is the character which makes us a gentleman. It is not the kind of body clothes and other kind of things which make the leaders. So that is how the kind of dress that you are wearing is remarkable, and hopefully you will be able to create the marvels with this. And to become the leader, the passion is absolute essential. That kind of passion has been shown our leader. You must be aware of the example of J.R.D. Tata. Once he was given the opportunity, he was just passing through some in front of the Arabian Sea, which is in Mumbai. There was a Watson Hotel. Watson Hotel at that point of time in 1880s was the property, kind of you can say, for the English people, wherein only the English people were encouraged to go. And one Lawrence Brothers movie was being showcased there.
And J.R.D. Tata, as a young person, wanted to witness that movie, but he was being refused because he was an Indian. J.R.D. Tata, at that point of time, he had one passion in his mind, that I would create one wonderful hotel in front of this very hotel wherein only Indians will be allowed. So that is the initiation he had taken, and it came in the form of famous Hotel Taj. I hope you are most aware of this Hotel Taj. Nobody is aware of Hotel Watson. So this is the passion. The lead, being leaders, you need to have some kind of dream, you need to have some kind of passion, and change your passion into the ground realities, change into the success stories. That is it. Whatever you want to do, pursue it with great passion, and you need to have the full energy, full vigor of yours. You try to pursue that passion and success will be yours. You, as a leader, I understand, leader is to lead the crowd, but you should always be at the back of the crowd. That is my advice, because you need to take the team along with you. You should have a great cooperation you need to show. Give the opportunity to the team members also. They should also be able to show their talents. Ultimate aim and the goal of the leader is not to create the lead, not to create the followers, but to create the leaders. See, you need to see what kind of qualities or the traits your fellow being has. You need to definitely uplift those. You need to bring out those. You should always be ready, truthfulness with all absolute integrity, honesty, confidence. You should be able to help your teammates and try to bring whatever the objectives and aim are there in front of the group, they should be realized. Another thing that I successful story that comes into my mind at this juncture was of APJ Abdul Kalam Azad. He was being spotted. He was a very normal student, below poverty. He's always stayed throughout his life. As a young boy, he was being spotted by Vikram Sarabhai. Now he's, you all know, our late president, honorable president, is known as the missile man of India. He was being spotted, he was being found out. He was just a normal boy who used to take lots of interest in the studies. He read a lot, and then he was being inspired by his teachers, and then he was being spotted by Vikram Sarabhai. He brought him to the center where the missiles are being launched, and where there he learned various lessons. One lesson he learned is how to take up the successes and the failures. And this is another story when he launched one of the missile, which was a great failure. Initially it was a failure. And the missile which he launched, that fell into Arabian Sea. And the second time, but his leader was Ashok Dhawan, and he assured, he held a press conference to tell everyone, this time it's my failure. It has happened. So such kind of leader has to be. Entire blame he has taken up on him. And he said, my people will work very well next year. And the very next year, the missile launch was a great success. That is how it is the duty of the leader to take up all the share of the blame, not all, maybe the partial blame of the share onto you. And then the credit should be very less of his. Then only the team works. So these lessons you must hear, you must learn, you may read them, you may have some successful stories in front of you that you can read them, and you try to copy a character who aspires you. There are not many people who can aspire you in India and abroad, and try to see what kind of passion, what kind of love that you have in your life, what liking do you have in your life. Try to pursue within passion and the success will be yours. And these are the attributes which I have already highlighted. I am sure you will, if a few you follow, you will become the great leaders. And seeing you sitting in the sun is also a great concern for me. Otherwise, I can keep going on, talking a lot to you. It's a great opportunity being provided. And thank you so much for the school principal, vice principal, and all the faculty staff for giving me this opportunity. And I wish you all the very best in your endeavors. Thank you.
No. Ganeshay Jain Madam, the Director of School of Planning and Architecture, Vijayawada. Respected Principal of this venue school, Brother Lawrence D'Souza, and respected Vice Principal, Brother Mala Reddy Garu, and respected other dignitaries present of the dais, media persons, parents, respected learned colleagues, and my dear loving children.
A very good morning to all of you. So it's a great privilege for me to be here in this prestigious institution. Because why am I mentioning this prestigious institution? Because I'm a native of Vijayawada. I know about this school since my childhood. Though I may not have studied this institution, but I know very well about it because I studied in 7th Adventist High School, Vijayawada. In the year 1979, I studied ICSE syllabus. But I know very well about this institution, very prestigious institution run by the Montfort brothers, which they signify that dedication, devotion, hard work, everything. Really, it's a matter of pride for me to be here in this institution. And once when a brother invited me, principal brother invited me to this function, he clearly told over telephone just to speak 5 minutes regarding leadership. Only 5 minutes. So I thought to refer books also to speak because this is because every day you students are seeing your leaders. Who are your great leaders? Teachers and principal. So whatever they do in this institution, you see them, observe them and follow them. Right? See, the father of leadership, Professor Baron G. Venis, is a father of leadership, American scholar, writer of many books on leadership. He has given one quotation on leadership. Leadership or a leader is a person who always do the right thing. Who always do the right thing. And he also differentiated manager is a person who does the things right. So what is meant by doing the right thing and doing the things right? There is a slight difference, isn't it? Here are two things to be noted. A leader, whatever he does is right. It is in the autocratic rule. Whatever a leader does, it is right. And in the democratic rule, and whatever a leader does will be right. So here, a leader always do things right or right things and has to do the right things. So today, whatever the students inducted in the cabinet as house captain, vice captain, and house school captain, school vice captain, house captain, secretaries, all those who are inducted, you have to note down that you have to do only the right things, not the wrong things. Because leadership is a matter of intelligence. Leadership is a matter of intelligence and trustworthiness. Leadership must be trustful. And leadership is a matter of courage. And leadership is a matter of discipline. So all the relevant fields, you have to strive to maintain all these things. Not only you must be intelligent, you must be trustworthyful, and you must be humanness. You must maintain humanity also. So leaders must be humanity, maintain humanity. So today, whoever inducted in this captain or vice captain in the cabinet, you have to know your role very much and you have to identify the purpose of your induction into the cabinet and you have to make priorities of doing the things to be done in the school for the development and you have to try to be efficient and successfully reach the goal and also you have to get trained also through your teachers. So I hope that definitely you will maintain in the coming days. My best wishes to all of you in this regard and God bless you all. Thank you for giving me this opportunity, Principal Brother Lawrence Brother for inviting me to this function and thank you all. And whatever I have witnessed this activity is really, you people definitely in the coming days, in the future that I have all will be very, very, very good leaders. Perfect march fast and perfect dancing, everything excellent. And thanks to the organizing committee. And one thing I would like to tell you, do not be like a free floating balloon in air which has no destination, but be like a race horse which wins or loses the race within a fraction of seconds. Because if you see the horse race, one cannot decide with normal eyes which horse has won. The computer decides. Do you agree or not? Because in a fraction of microseconds, the winning or losing will be there. So today's competitive world is also like that. So please keep one destination or goal and try to achieve those goals and become a proud citizen of this great country, India. Jai Hind, Mera Bharat Mahan. Thank you so all.
P. Harsha of 7th B, Asmi of 50th, Secure National, and K. Devi Amrita. Merit and Wheel Scholarships in Maths and Science 2017.
We also extend our immense gratitude to Mr. J. Sunil Kumar, who was magnanimous enough to give his consent for being our distinguished guest today. The presence of both our dignitaries has truly raised our spirits.
Sir, Ravi, are you ready to just say?
Okay, nice friend. Punchu, good friend.
Principal Balaridhi, too, has been a great pillar of strength, lending his untiring support to the staff and students of NSM, and we are extremely thankful to him too.
No event or program can be turned out so meticulously if our dear teachers did not perpetually lead us as our guides, philosophers and friends. We today thank them all for their everlasting efforts for us.
We would be failing in our duties if we did not thank our parents who have gathered here in large numbers to appreciate, applaud and encourage us. So a big thank you to
all the parents, guests and well-wishers of our school.
A heartfelt thanks to our quiet workers behind the scenes who deserve special mention, for without their technical support, this program would never have been possible.
A big thanks to the print and electronic media too for their coverage of today's program.
Last but not the least, we bow our heads in thanking the Lord Almighty who blessed us today with the great weather to make the ceremony a grand success.
Thank you one and all.
Thank you, Master.